Alfred Adult Beginner, Level 1, page 46. The song is Standing in the Need of Prayer. We're going to be now doing everything we've kind of learned, going back to that C position, the original one that we started in. And we're going to be playing with eighth notes and crescendos and decrescendos and playing legato and all that stuff. So let's take a quick listen to the piece, and then we'll talk about the details. Talk about a few things, because I didn't do it because I'm always trying to make the videos a little bit shorter, but that isn't the end of the song right as finished. You're supposed to go back to the beginning of the song and play to the word fine, because at the end of the song we have what it says there is DC al fine, which means to repeat from the beginning and then play until you see the word fine, which, or as most people say, fine, but it's the end of the second bar. So that's the actual end. So if you're playing for your teacher and you don't do that, they might give you some trouble about it, so make sure you understand that that's what you're supposed to do. Okay, let's go over a couple quick things. You need to be keeping a beat on this one. So we talked about counting and happy birthday on the last page. You should probably write in your beats and, you know, confine the song to groups of two measures and then count after you're good at the notes. Don't write in the beats and then try to count and play when you're first learning. That's nuts, so don't do that. So if you're counting slow and playing, do the right hand first. Be like this. 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Okay, I did it slow. I can play the notes. And then I can start adding the left hand maybe. 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So get good at that. Now you don't have to count out loud, but it helps some people. You can count in your mind. If that isn't working and counting's giving you trouble, you can use a metronome. A little click-click thing. A lot of my students hate them. You should be able to play to a metronome, though. You should be able to play to that beat. It's another skill that you can learn. And you're not really counting, per se. You're just trying to keep up with that rhythm or that tempo. Okay. Now, a couple things here. As we're playing along, you'll notice there are some eighth notes. And it sounds like I'm playing these notes much faster because I have to, because they're only going to have a beat. So as we're playing along, make sure that you write in your beats using and. So one and, two and, three and, because we have to represent every half beat. So when we encounter eighth notes, we can count it properly. So I'm going to start on the third full measure where it says standing in the need of. And I'm going to count that very slowly, but listen to what I'm talking about here for the eighth notes. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and, okay? Now, if we were playing faster, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So you can see it now. Of what it was sounding like when I was playing it. Now, let's jump down to the third bar, because I think we've covered the main two things in the first two bars. The third bar, we've got E starting in the right hand, and the next note is D sharp. So just reviewing, D is here, sharps go up a half step, so D sharp is here, okay? And we can count. So, 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and. Now you can play faster. Or slower when you're first learning. I recommend slower. Everybody wants to go too fast too soon. Okay, so that's basically how those parts are going. We are trying to play legato. We've got a few parts here we're trying to do a crescendo, so try to do that if you can't, it's not a big deal. At the very end, we've got a decrescendo we're doing. Okay, try to bring down the volume if you can. If you can't, don't worry about it. Try to keep the beat, play the right notes. Right now, those two things should be your main focus. Okay, if you can get anything else with the legato or the crescendos or anything, that would be great too, but those should not be your main focus at this point. All right, thanks for watching. That concludes Standing in the Need of Prayer.